Santoro stood out in a team that was made up of the goalkeeper being Ryder, the right back being Malcolm Rufus, the left back being Stewart, the centre back Stan Jacobi, and the two midfielders was Charlie Goff, Joe Frickleton. On the right hand side we had Bobby Hume. Then come in, number 8, Jorge Santoro. Then the striker forward, it was Walter Da Silva. Number 10 was Freddie Kalk. And on the left-hand side, Willie McIntosh. That team beat everybody. He made football to appear beautiful. It appeared good. Not the hard work that you see under players exerting themselves like Joe Frickleton. You could see he was using so much power. It's in his tackles, you know. Georgie, it was just effortless because he was coming from inside. And that's where I deduce that it could have been something from above. It was something special. And I saw him as a messiah sent to make us happy. Because why we talk about one player with so many good players in that team? I mean, Bobby Hume was a very good player. He never looked at the ball, he used to look at somebody's eye. Same thing I called with McIntosh. But we all spoke about Jorge Santoro. That's why whenever we go to Highlands Park to watch a game, we're always looking for Jorge Santoro. Because when you go home, there's a story to tell. There's discussion about how you pass the ball. There's a discussion how you accept the ball. There's discussion how he runs. There's discussion how he hugs. And when he scores, how he jumps. So there was so much of him that fulfilled that loneliness in most of us because of the enclosure that we were confined with. We were so crowded in that enclosure. But whenever he touched the ball, we never felt the squeezeness of the space. We felt this kind of exuding of emotions, of pleasure, of happiness. When you go home, maybe Santoro, Santoro, Santoro. I mean, Santoro, after the game, we always go and hug him. It was always amenable. There was no distance between anybody. So for us, you know, Jorge, he represents that quality of player, which fortunately in my team, Orlando Pirates had those kind of players. We had Jomo Sono, we had Keza Mutawu, we had Chipa Chipa Mudoni. Exactly the same kind of footballers. So it was resonating with the kind of football we were used to. So for us, it was a messiah sent, you know, to give us the happiness that we don't have at that particular time in the era of this country.